Hey guys, Charlie here, and in today's video, I'll be going through another DeFi project which is called Swarm Finance. Swarm Finance is a yield aggregator protocol, or what you call as a yield optimizer, on Binance Smart Chain Network. But before I deep dive into what Swarm Finance is and whether should you invest in Swarm Finance native token, I would like to share with you that we are having this giveaway contest for our crypto starter pack that consists a copy of our book Crypto Assets for Passive Income, an online video course, and a $20 worth of Bitcoin. If you have been struggling to find hidden gems to invest in, or just starting out in your cryptocurrency investing journey, you will want to participate in this giveaway contest to kickstart on the right footing. The links to participate is in the description box down below. If you are new to our channel, do hit that subscribe button and enable the notification bell for more videos such as this. You can also join our socials such as our Twitter and Telegram group TokenClan for more in-depth discussion on cryptocurrencies and blockchain technology. Without further ado, let's get started. Right now, we are at defistation.io, our go-to data aggregation platform whereby we discover new DeFi projects on the Binance Smart Chain. And in today's session, we will be talking about Swarm Finance that is ranked 17 here. You can see that it's a native token. It's called Swarm, and it is currently trading at $77.85 with a TVL of $197 million. And this is their interface. Just a quick look at their interface. And their current TVL, as of now, is close to 200 million. Considered small compared to other yield aggregators out there on the Binance Smart Chain. But still, it's something that we want to take a look at. And you can consider as an option for your yield farming strategy. But first, for any new projects, we will want to go through their documentation first. And this is Swarm Finance documentation. So what is Swampy token? So Swarm token is a governance token native to the Swarm Finance ecosystem and is a yield optimizer on the Binance Smart Chain network. And its main utility is for participation in voting on Swarm DAO proposals as an incentive to deposit their assets in Swarm Finance. Vault users are getting this bonus yield in Swampy. How do you obtain Swarm or purchase Swarm? The main exchange will be on PancakeSwap. PancakeSwap is in fact one of the largest decentralized exchange on the Binance Smart Chain. If you are still not familiar with PancakeSwap, I urge you to go and watch our previous videos that we have covered on PancakeSwap. And this is something that you do not want to miss out on, especially if you are looking at the Binance Smart Chain. And again, they mentioned that it is a yield optimizer that employs more efficient utilization of gas as well as other automated processes and uses different yield strategies to help users such as yourself to grow your assets through automation. So next, take a look at their basics, Swarm Vaults. But before we look at the vaults, we take a look at their tokenomics and fees first. You can see that Swarm has this reward distribution. And their max supply cap is at 2 million Swarm tokens, which is on the lower side because there is a lot of projects out there that has higher supply cap, whereas for Swarm has only 2 million tokens, which is on the lower side. It also explains why Swarm tokens is priced on the higher side. By engaging their platform or interacting their platform, definitely there are costs involved, so you need to know that when you do your deposits to perform yield farming, there is a 0.1%, and as well as other fees, a total of 4% on your profits. And I have clarified with some admins on Telegram. They mentioned that all these fees, especially the 4% on profits, are already accounted for their APY and rewards calculation. What you see on the screen is what you get. And next, we look at the Swarm Vaults. Through their Swarm Vaults, they already have filtered and showcased to you which are the active vaults with this green check mark here, and those vaults that has this auto compound feature. In fact, all of them have it except for, I believe, their Swarm pool itself. So you can see if you stake Swarm to receive Swarm, there is no auto compound feature, which is common in fact, all of the projects I've seen so far, except for maybe PancakeSwap that I've seen, they have this auto compound feature just introduced recently. And one thing you can see that the vaults is quite diverse. They have vaults from different platforms. This is quite good as an investor because you have more options to choose. That includes your popular PancakeSwap platforms. The recently covered project ApeSwap is also in it as well. MDEX, Venus, Belt. This is something that is quite exciting to know. And their smart contracts, so the contract addresses. Something that you need to know when you perform your swap to ensure that you are swapping for the right tokens. And let's take a look at their roadmap. So their roadmap is very short and simple here. Currently, we are in the month of May. They have this plan of this swap DAO and voting. Later on, we will see whether they have implemented this or not. Security and risk. So they mentioned about the risk of DeFi projects like the smart contract risk, and the impermanent loss risk with regards to LP tokens. And they have their audits. They have an audit on tech rate, and their certain audit is in progress. So something to look out for. This project is only about 2 months old because based on their Twitter, they launched it in the mid of March. So it's about 2 months old. Something to look out for here. And their FAQ includes tutorials on how to use the wallets like MetaMask and other apps to interact with their Swarm Finance interface. Last but not least is their social channels like their Twitter, their Telegram, which are more active. And I highly encourage you to engage with their community to understand more about this platform. Next, we go to their main application. You can see it's quite a clean application. Easy to navigate, and at the top right hand corner here there is a drop down menu. You can navigate through here. You have your tutorials, your documentation. They have their own YouTube tutorials that you can look at on how to interact with this Swarm Finance. My sharing today will be just have a brief walkthrough on their application to familiarize yourself with this interface. And as you can see, you have all the vaults here, which is their main feature. Based on what I've seen here, they do not have their DAO set up yet. It's something to look for this month. And you can see, they keep adding on new vaults. This is very important for investors because you may be holding different tokens. And you can see, especially because Swarm is quite a new project, so they offer very attractive rewards here. And they included like some of these single token vaults as well. Something that you need to take note of. Like for example, you know, this IBNB that is interacting with this BZH platform. So you can see that it is 50.1% APY. If I'm not wrong, it definitely rivals what AutoFarm is offering as well, because AutoFarm has this IBNB vault and it's quite competitive. So you might want to take a look and do your comparisons between Swarm and AutoFarm. There are other U aggregators that you can look at, but I can say that a brief look at what the returns they are giving right now is attractive and competitive. Of course, your cake. So if you want to stake cake to earn pure cake rewards, this is also a place that you can consider. And they have their breakdown of the farm APY and the Swarm APR. You can see that not only do you get cake as your rewards, you also get the Swarm token as your reward. So you have two rewards. The first part, this part, the APY, is you are getting cake, which is auto-compounded, and Swarm APR. For the Swarm part, it's not, I believe it's not auto-compounded, but it is best to confirm this information with their Telegram admin or their project admin to understand more about these things. States here, auto-compounded yield, which is the cake, and I believe this is not auto-compounded, so they just give you as it is. Your banana, so from ApeSwap. This is the project which I have recently covered. It is something that if, let's say, you decide to get into ApeSwap, this is one of the platforms where you can stake your banana and get it auto-compounded here. Because ApeSwap doesn't have this auto-compound feature for their banana farm. And not only that, you are able to get Banana as well as Swarm tokens. Good deal, I should say. I also want to highlight, like, Swarm pools or Swarm vaults do not have this auto compound feature. So you can see that it is only providing you these APR returns. If you want to do this compounding, you need to do it manually, especially when it involves Swarm tokens. For this LP farming, it is auto compounded, but for the Swarm tokens, if you get the Swarm tokens, it won't be auto compounded. You need to do it yourself. One strategy is that perhaps, let's say you are farming this LP pool and you get your Swarm tokens, maybe perhaps each week you can put your Swarm tokens into this farm here, just Swarm, to get more Swarm. This is a very simple strategy to execute. Another thing is that we want to go into CoinMarketCap just to understand some of the data. And right now, Swarm at about $80. Let's go to the site. So it's $77. So this is not up to date yet. And you can see the past history. So relatively, it is like trading in a range. And also, it features some of the markets that you can obtain Swarm. So PancakeSwap and Dodo. But most of the volume is on PancakeSwap. This is where you want to go to in order to get lower pricing and low slippage as well. Then comes to the next important question. Should I invest in Swarm tokens? My answer to you is that if only you are using Swarm tokens to perform UFarm strategies, then will you use this platform? But for me, whenever I encounter a new DeFi project, I will not immediately purchase their tokens unless I strongly believe in that project. For this Swarm Finance, because if I have this need to perform my U farming strategies on Swarm itself, I will receive this Swarm token as a reward. Basically, I do not really need to purchase Swarm tokens up front. Just by performing this U farming strategies here, I will get these Swarm tokens as my reward. When I get more of them, I can stake Swarm here to receive more Swarm. So this is my opinion on how I approach this Swarm token. I would actually not purchase their token using my crypto assets or my money, but rather I see Swarm Finance as a tool to perform my U farming strategy. So I will receive Swarm as a reward. When I'm talking about features wise and yield returns wise, I will not just look at Swarm alone. I will definitely look at other yield aggregators out there like AutoFarm, PancakeBunny and other yield aggregators to see which one I'm comfortable in staking as well as the rewards. This is how I will approach when I invest or commit my crypto tokens to the platform itself. One thing to note, of course, Swarm is a new yield aggregator platform with their smart contract getting audited by CERTIC, which is still in progress. So that is a point that you need to take note of if you want to put it into Swarm. Do look out for that. With that, I hope you have enjoyed my introduction to Swarm Finance. Please drop a like and leave a comment down below. What do you think of this Swarm Finance and how does it compare to other yield aggregators out there? If you are new to our channel, do hit that subscribe button and enable the notification bell. Also, join our socials such as our Twitter and Telegram channel, TokenClan, for more in-depth discussions on cryptocurrencies. Do participate in our giveaway contest for our Crypto Starter Pack. All the links are in the description box down below. With that, I'll see you in the next video.